Are you have a brain?
I understand. What else would you like to know?
Hello, guys. Today, in this episode, I will introduce my new AI voice assistant. In this tutorial includes server build, Arduino firmware, and how to use. This AI assistant completely free. I don't use paid anything. Just subscribe my channel and like this video. Let's begin. Firstly, we gonna talk about Assistant. In this project, using AI model working on HuggingFace server, ESP32 working like a client. That means voice recording and audio playing on ESP32, and the other all AI processing running on HuggingFace server like a speech-to-text AI model, large language model, and text-to-speech model. Further, I bring together three model and running on one server. This is not to be easy for me. For a now, Assistant supported only English language. Also, I selected model supported multi-language, but when tried to this version, I keep getting a ridiculous answer, decoding my voice wrongly, so that I chose to use only one language support. If this project get in hype, I will improve that. Let's look hardware. I use ESP32S3 development board, 16 megabytes flash, 8 megabytes piece RAM version. I am underlined piece RAM. This is important. Other way, code doesn't work properly, cause of using voice recording task. After, I am telling about in code section, ST7789 TFT display. If you don't know how to use this screen with ESP32 on Arduino, you must be check out this tutorial. I am telling everything about a configuration, using, wiring, etc. Links are description. Next, I use Max 98357A I2S audio amplifier and INMP441 I2S MEMS microphone. Both of them use an I2S communication, also can share a same I2S GPIO pins, but didn't choose this way. I separated two different I2S line because when try to use same I2S pin for both of them, get a noise, complicated control, sometimes didn't correctly installed, etc. So I simplified separated, doesn't complex anymore. Don't forget to add a capacitor between ground and VCC on INMP441 microphone. By the way, I connect to Amplfier half watt 8 ohm speaker. And lastly, using a tactile button for trigger to record. As you can see, all connection GPIO goes to where on the screen, also using button example. Watch out in display tutorial videos, connection is different from in this project. You can choose same GPIO within this project or any free GPIO. If you're confused or need to know much more detail about this microphone module, audio amplifier, and I2S communication, watch this video. In that project, I was shared a voice recorder project with same component and same connection. Let's continue with server. We are going huggingface.com. After we are create a free account, when account is created, press your profile icon and then click a new space section. In this page, we are generate an AI server. In this section, you can see your user ID, write in your space name, any specific name is assume. Description and license not necessary, but you can fill and select a license. I leave an empty. Crawling page. Choose a space SDK. We choose a Docker SDK and blank template. Select a space hardware, CPU basic. Leave a server type a public and then click create space button. Now we are in server configuration page. We seen start to build information. Actually, you don't need to know. I explain every step need to know. Also, I share all server file on my GitHub page. Links are description. For now, write in no application file in state view. When server is online, we seen in this label, write in running. We are going to file section on the top menu. You seen page like a GitHub repo. Click Contribute, and then create a new file. Go to GitHub page, open Dockerfile, and copy it inside. Turn to server, write file name. Write an exactly same Dockerfile. First character is upper letter, rest of them lower. In this blank, pasted your copied from GitHub, and then click Commit New File to Main button. Now we are created first file on own server. We are repeated this process 3 times. Go to GitHub page, open app file, copied inside, turn to server, create a new file, write file name app.py, paste it into blank your copied, and then click Commit New File to Main. Go to GitHub page, open Docker Compose file, copied inside, turn to server, create a new file. Write file name docker-compose.yml, paste it into blank your copied, and then click Commit New File to Main. Go to GitHub page, open requirements file, copied inside, turn to server, create a new file, write file name requirements.txt, paste it into blank your copied, and then click Commit New File to Main. When every file is created, look at state label, must be seen building, starting, and then running. First install, it's take a time. We need to make one more thing on server. Creating access token. Again, go to profile icon and click access token. If get authorization, confirm with your password, and then create a new token. Select a token type is write, give a name, doesn't matter, and click create token. Copied token and don't be share anyone. Click done. Turn your server. Now click settings. Scrolling page. Find secrets. Create a new secret. Give a name HF token. This name must be same. Value is your token pasted in here. And click save. All you thing doing correctly, but get a build error. In this situation, change your readme.md file inside in your server with my version released on GitHub page. After doing this, you can see server is running. Server part is done. We keep going on Arduino. In this part, we need to install a few libraries, and we need to change a few things. First, we start Arduino. Arduino firmware published on my GitHub page links are description. Go to my link, copied Arduino code, and paste it in Arduino. Also, all you need libraries links are description. Go to links, download libraries, and install your Arduino. May be confused when see ESP8266 audio libraries. It's fine, working pretty well with ESP32. Start redefine. Write your SSD and password information in here. ESP32 need to Wi-Fi access. And the other important thing is server URL. Change with your server information. Watch out upper and lower letter. Rest of the code be same. Configure your development board tools. Settings and don't forget to open PCRAM. Cause of this software need to use PCRAM. Other way, get an error in project or compile error. Also, select a partition. Must include SPFFS. Again, use spy software on ESP32, we talking before. Click upload. When everything is complete, seen on display, write in assistant ready. That means your AI voice assistant is ready to use. Press to button when keep pressed, your voice recording in PCRAM. When released button, record is stop. Voice sending automatically server. You can seen on display and server page. AI server take a voice, firstly speech to text. After asking to large language model, LLM, create an answer. Finally, text to speech and server sending back a new audio to ESP32. ESP32 download audio to little file system. When it done, automatically play on speaker. I am getting better AI assistant, much faster and stable. Keep on follow, like and share this video and hit that subscribe button. I have too much fun when I creating this project. Now your turn. Enjoy, See you in next episode.
Are you have a brain?
I understand. What else would you like to know?
What is the capital of Turkey?
It's a great video, and you can watch it all over again.
What is the capital of United States?